One of the nation's top quarterbacks takes the field tonight as the long summer comes to an end and college football is back. Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh is the site. ACC football is next. You're watching the ACC on ESPN, and we welcome you to Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh, North Carolina. Better than 55,000 on hand for the season opener as NC State hosts Troy on this first Saturday of the college football season. 48 games across the ESPN family of networks. We're glad you've chosen this one. Alex Faust, Stan Luter here with you. And Stan, a lot of excitement around this NC State program. Potential contenders in the ACC for the championship this year.
Oh, so much excitement. This was the hottest team in the ACC near the end, winning four out of their last five. Win. So, yeah, they're excited about things, but you know what? Troy's excited, too. They've got a new coach, new staff, new ideas. This could be a good ball game.
Should be a good quarterback battle here tonight as well. Jacoby Brissett going up against Brandon Silvers, and for Brissett, he was one of the better quarterbacks in the country last year.
I really like Jacoby Brissett. One of the reasons why he's a leader, he's a tough player, makes smart plays, 23 touchdown passes last season. In addition to his ability to see the field, he can throw the deep pass, he can throw the long pass. Can also run the football. Last season, he rushed for over 500 yards, leading the Wolfpack to a bowl bid. Keep your eye on him. And then there's the sophomore, Brandon Silvers. Now, here's the thing about Silvers. Only a sophomore, but established an NCAA record in percentage as a freshman, passing for over 70%. He only threw four interceptions on 16 touchdown passes. Silvers, Brissett, keep your eye on these two guys.
5 months from now, we'll crown a national champion. Today, it's time to get week one done. Kickoff between NC State and Troy on the way next. Hear the soundtrack of college football once again. Troy and NC State set to go at it here in Raleigh. We had some rain move through not too long ago, soaked the field, soaked all the tailgaters, but it is swept through, clearing out. Should be a nice night for football here. Well, Troy, brand new head coach, Neil Brown. First season as a head coach and one of the youngest in the country at age 35. Dave Doran for NC State, his third season. They're looking to raise the bar from an 8-5 campaign last year. Troy won the toss. They elect to receive the opening kickoff. And Stan, this should be a fun one. Two good quarterbacks, as we talked about in the open. An NC State team that's riding a wave of momentum after a great finish last year. Can't wait to get this game going. Referee Pat Garvey giving final instructions. NC State will kick off. A freshman to do the kicking for the Wolfpack. Kyle Bambard, wearing number 92, will do the duties. It's an all-freshman kicking crew for NC State here this year. Set for football in Raleigh. Bambard's ready, and away we go. Short kick, and it'll be taken at the Troy 5. This is Teddy Rubin finding some space to the outside. He's knocked down at the 20. That is where Troy will start, and Brandon Silvers, sophomore quarterback, great numbers last year, broke the NCAA record for completion percentage by a freshman. In pretty good company with that record, he broke Sam Bradford's old record from Oklahoma. He'll be a lot of fun to watch. It's an up-tempo Troy offense as well, Stan. They're going to run tempo at some points, but hearing from Neil Brown, it might depend on how well they execute on first down here. We'll see what they do on their first series. Spread offense is the hallmark of a Troy football team as well. And Silver's on a keeper going nowhere. Take a look at our impact players, Stan. Who you got?
Brandon Burks, keep your eye on number 32, the running back for Troy University. He's led the team in rushing the last two seasons. Going to have to get off to a good start. And Gerard Fernandez, four games this last year, he had 10 tackles or more. Very active, number four.
Hand off in the backfield. Brandon Burks, again, very little to do before he's wrapped up. Only a two-yard gain to get back to the original line of scrimmage, and there's your impact player right off the bat.
This is an NC State team that's very veteran, even though they're very young. All night, the names of Gerard Fernandez and the nickelback, Davion Wright, also Terrence Moore. But the guy that makes this defensive end, number 90, Big Mike Rose.
Troy wants to establish the run game, but first two plays from scrimmage haven't brought him very much. Silver's looking for options, escapes the pressure, but can't get enough for a first down. And it'll be a three and out in the first series of the game for the Trojans.
North Carolina State does a great job in the secondary, not allowing receivers to get there. And as we told you, this is a very aggressive defense. They're going to be after you all night long. A young offensive line for Troy getting pressure that time. Bradley Chubb, among others, on the tackle.
And we were talking with Dave Huxtable, defensive coordinator for NC State. They got more aggressive as the year went along last season. Punted back out to midfield by Ryan Kay. And NC State will have good field position when we come back. Early going here in Raleigh. NC State and Troy opening up the season. Great crowd on hand in Raleigh, and they'll get their first glimpse of Jacoby Brissett, the redshirt senior, as NC State takes over near midfield after a short 38-yard punt by Troy. But Brissett, only one of two quarterbacks in the Power 5 that had 2,000 passing yards, 300 rushing yards, 20 passing touchdowns. It's something to watch here for NC State. Dropping back at his first series, too. Lots of time, and he works it to the near sideline. David Brinage on the reception, and Brissett with one completion in his first pass.
Great offensive line, and we'll talk a lot about them as you look at Brissett's numbers. 2,600 yards passing, only five interceptions, takes care of the football, but a nice pocket pass, plenty of protection, and Greenwich, one of those outstanding receivers that we'll talk a lot about this day and throughout this season. 6'5", 265 pound, tight end, they had him outside.
21-yard completion for the junior and a first and 10 past midfield. Off play action, Matt Days picks up a couple here. Days, one of our impact players, Stan, one of the best runners, no one of the best running backs in the ACC.
No question about Matt Days, and also very versatile. Eight touchdowns, five touchdowns catching the football. One of the players that they really depend on. And again, Montrez Kitchen, a versatile guy, kick returner, plays great defense, a preseason all-conference performer, number one.
NC State looking to establish the run game early as well. Even though they were one of the most balanced offenses in the country last year, they weren't afraid to keep pounding it on the ground. This pass complete. Just past the hashes to Jonathan Alston. 5-yard gain. And they'll bring up third and short.
North Carolina State would prefer to just run the ball and pound it. As they talk about here, they run to win, they throw to score. But they can take care of the football and that versatility. It's a third down situation last year. They were a team that was third best in the ACC, 81 out of 177 on the season.
Those three receivers to the left in a formation down here near side right. Brissett with instructions of the line of scrimmage. Third and three. Off the play fake. Brissett scrambling, looking for room. Might have enough for the first down. It'll be close. I think he might be just short, though.
Troy does a really nice job of containing Brissett. They overloaded one side, then switched over. Brissett, nowhere to go. Great job defensively. And then what you've got to do if you're the Trojans of Troy today, you've got to be sure tacklers. William Lloyd, among others, on the tackle. Here we go, fourth down.
No question about it. You're in this part of the field. NC State wants to go for it on fourth down. Short yardage to go. Brissett off the draw play. Matt Days easily has enough. And they'll move the sticks. NC State having their way with the Trojans early on.
Matt Days was a very consistent player last season. Didn't really run for big numbers, but they used him a lot of ways. As we said, he caught a lot of passes out of the backfield, 32 receptions. Also carried the ball 104 times and those 8 touchdowns for the Wolfpack. They'll use him a lot today in different ways.
Motion up front, flag comes in. Might be a free play anyway, but Days only able to pick up a couple. And we'll hear from Pat Garvey for the first time tonight.
Offside. Defense number 7. 5 yards. Spot, replay, first down.
And that's Rashad Dillard, one of the JUCO transfers for Troy.
What you cannot do if you're Troy is give North Carolina State extra plays, free plays. You had them in a fourth and short situation, not able to stop them there. Great effort. But then on the next play, you're offsides. And any play that you give NC State a second chance opportunity, they're going to take full advantage of it.
It's a very young secondary for Troy. And they struggled in third and fourth down stops last year. Brissett off first down. Got his man near sideline. Naheem Hines, the freshman. Homegrown talent, the true freshman, picks up his first catch.
Man, they are excited about this young kid, Naheem Hines. He's a speedster. But play him out of the slot, comes against formation, catches. First catch of many throughout his NC State history. But one of those athletes that if you want to take your program to the next level, you've got to have a guy like Naheem Hines from Garner, North Carolina, right down the road. 38 touchdowns on his season last year.
5-yard pickup, enough for a first down. 7th play of the drive for NC State. Run up the middle and a broken play defensively for Troy. That could have been stopped at the line of scrimmage, but Matt Days able to rumble forward for another field.
Well, this is an offensive line at North Carolina State led by Joe Thuney, number 54, that don't mind pounding. They want to get it down and dirty. See a nice little peelback block there by Alex Barr, 71. Schooley, number 60, the center. And again, all you've got to do for Matt Days is give him a couple of feet. Boom, he can get by you. He took nothing and made something out of that.
8 rushing touchdowns for Matt Days last year. Play to the outside. Easy work of it. Jalen Samuels with a touchdown. NC State on the board. 14-yard touchdown run and liftoff inside of 7 minutes for the Wolfpack.
You're talking about speed, none better than Jalen Samuel. Just a little fly sweep, catch it, touchdown, walk down the field, nobody there. Great job of execution on the first time you get the football for NC State.
And here's that all-freshman kicking crew for the Wolfpack. And the first extra point attempt. Easy work of it for Kyle Bambard, the freshman. NC State with an effortless drive downfield. 7-0 to the Wolfpack early on in Raleigh. NC State with a touchdown in their first series of the game. Stan, it was easy work in just 8 plays.
It was so nice. I mean, you've got perfect execution by the offense. And when you can get that, and we'll see this in a second. Now, take a look at the top of the screen when we see Greenwich does a great job with a kick block, and boom, it's so easy. Some of the fans haven't even gotten in their seat yet. Kidding me?
Quick 62-yard drive in 4 minutes, 17 seconds for NC State. Jackson Maples, the redshirt freshman, a kickoff. I'll go out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Stan, here's the score for NC State.
Alex, again, you want to get off to a great start offensively. You want to get your guys all in sync. Couldn't have been better than this. Watch the block at your top of the screen. Number 86, he kicks his defensive end, bam, holds him right there, and there's such a quick release there to Samuels. No one lays a hand on him. Great execution by North Carolina State. Give him 6.
8 plays, 62-yard scoring drive for NC State and a 7-0 lead. Now, Troy's got to figure out something. 3 and out on their first series.
The thing that you didn't want to do if you were Coach Brown is to start playing early uphill. Okay, so now they've got to settle in. They wanted to do something on first down. Keep your eye on first down runs and passes throughout this game.
First play from scrimmage for Troy. Much better look than he had in that first series. Enough to move the sticks. 11-yard gain for the Trojans, and that's a better look in the run game.
They would like to run anywhere between 80 and 90 plays in a ball game.
Inside handoff, and right away Teddy Rubin finding a crease and getting through check down. That's Brandon Burks.
Keep your eye on number 69, Dalton Bennett. Senior leader, does a really nice job blocking the point of attack. They like Bennett. They also like keep the number 57, Deontay Cromartie, a freshman, the first freshman to start on the offensive line for Troy in over 30 years. They feel like he's going to be a good one. He's going to be tested today.
Four receivers to choose from for Silvers, and he finds his man, DeAndre Douglas, the freshman, breaking a tackle and getting past midfield. It's a first down for Troy on a 16-yard gain for DeAndre Douglas.
Brandon Silvers, a surgeon last year and throwing the football, finds an open receiver. Douglas, a really good open field release, a little out route, catch it protected. They would rather their receivers catch the ball in front of them and make a play on the offensive side by running.
Off play action, inside handoff once again to Brandon Burks. He'll be their workman.
Yard after the catch, so very important for this Troy offense. They're a rhythm offense. Right now, they look good.
Second and seven for the Trojans here in this series, a lot better. Keep in mind all the young players on this Trojans offense as well. Spread out, five receiver set for Brandon Silvers on second down. Looking far sideline, and it's broken up. No, they caught it. It's a catch along the far sideline. It looked like he may have stepped out. 33-yard catch for Brian Holmes. Big play, Brian is his nickname, and he picks up a big one there. First and goal.
Upgrade had a solid season with 54 catches and five touchdowns. Just a simple go route. They had him locked in man coverage, and an excellent catch by Brian Holmes.
First and goal, and here's Burks picking up a couple. Well, this Troy Trojans offense, if they're working early on in first and second down.
Keep an eye on this play at the top of your screen. Again, nice protection by the offensive line and just a wonderful catch. Get it? Yo, easily, very easy.
Saw the tip and he managed to haul it in.
Jack Tocho, one of the outstanding defensive backs for NC State. Got a little burn on that play.
Silvers, handoff. Burks, touchdown, Troy. Well, how about that for a response? And it's Jordan Chun, who led the country in rushing touchdowns by a freshman last year, number one in 2015.
Power football. Stay low, keep grinding. One, two, three guys hit, but it doesn't matter. You just keep turning and turning. And Jordan Chun gets in the end zone. And early on, Troy says, look, you want to score on us? We can come right back and score.
Well, this is what we were thinking, Stan, for this Troy team. If they could have some traction early on. Jared Solomon on to attempt the extra point. Won the job from Ryan Kay in camp. And the senior with his first try is plenty good. We got ourselves a ball game here in Rome. Troy Trojans have found an answer. After NC State punched one through on their first drive, the Trojans have tied it up. All square at 7 in the early going at Carter-Finley Stadium. Alex Faust, Stan Luter here with you. We got ourselves a little bit of a ball game here. Troy 3 and out in their first series. NC State punches it in. And then a surgical drive for Brandon Silvers and company.
Already an improvement from last year. They only scored 64 points in the first quarter of all their games. So this new offense by Coach Brown, he wants to spread you out. Hit them where they're not. So far, so good.
60-yard drive. Silvers 3 for 3. Remember, one of the most accurate passers in the NCAA last year.
And you have to remember, if you're North Carolina State, they looked at film from Kentucky, where Coach Brown was a coordinator, also some Troy. They've looked at a lot of things to try to get a gauge on what this team was going to do, what happens when you get a new coaching staff. So they'll settle down, tune in. They're talking to their guys right now to figure out exactly what the Troy Trojans are going to try to attempt.
Naheem Hines takes it a couple of yards deep for the touchback. These are the numbers that a lot of fans have in mind when it comes to balanced offense, but it's not so simple of just, well, we're going to run and then we're going to pass, and we're going to run and then we're going to pass. They'll do whatever it takes to win on any given day. And we heard from the coaches that they don't have a number in mind that they want to hit for rushing versus passing.
Well, like we said, they run to win, they throw to score. They had 26 rushing touchdowns, 24 passing touchdowns.
Well, now Jacoby Brissett and company are looking for an answer. First down to the 25 for the Wolfpack. They'll give it to Days on first down. That Days only good for a couple. Garrett Peake, the junior, moving up from second string this year on the stop.
Really excited about Garrett Peake. These two inside guys, Gosa and Peake, go about 300 pounds. And they feel like these two guys can kind of control the line of scrimmage, and it gives Jamal Statham and then the guy that everybody talks about in the Sun Belt, Tyler Ross, an opportunity to make some plays.
Brissett off play action, looking deep, pocket collapsing. Brissett to the near sideline, and Samuels hauls it in, falling to his knees. Jalen Samuels, and up for the first down.
And this is why Jacoby Brissett is being talked about as a possible Heisman candidate. Pressure inside, pocket collapse, gets to the outside, remains poised, finds an open receiver. That time Samuels, a nice catch, moves the sticks. But under pressure, a lot of quarterbacks will panic and try to make something out of nothing. He just takes his time and gets a first down.
Off first down, inside handoff to Days, getting past a tackler at the line of scrimmage and moves the sticks once again.
Versatility of Days. Nice kick block right there. See that great block on the inside that time? And one thing, if you're Troy, you don't want to get in this hand fighting game with this offensive line. This is an offensive line at NC State that averages about 305 pounds. They've got some veterans, Thuney at the left tackle, and Richardson's a young freshman at the other tackle. These guys are getting better and better, along with Adams, the young sophomore.
Days on his sixth carry of the ball game. Gets wrapped up near the line, but a flag comes in late.
Personal foul, face mask on the defense number 24. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, automatic first down.
Darius Rookard gets his hand in there at the end on Mays. They'll look right there. Easy call, and this again, the mistakes. Remember a moment ago was a fourth down, you get a step off and out of bounds, and then you offsides, and you can't make those mistakes in a game like this for Troy. You've got to play nearly perfect. They had a good drive a moment ago, but they've got to continue to play good solid defense.
Penalties weren't a huge problem for Troy last year. Days again jumping out of bounds near the marker. Matt Days has been the focal point of the offense early.
And give credit to this offensive line. Nice block there by Samuels. And Days just continues to grind and grind.
They'll give him enough for the first down as well. And C State driving. Matt Days up to 38 yards on seven carries. From the Troy 22. Brissett to Days again, and why not? Stumbling ahead for a gain of 8.
We talked to offensive coordinator Matt Canada. One of the things that he talks about in the entire offense about the versatility of this offensive line. And they kind of basically cross train. They teach a left tackle to play the right tackle in the left guard spot. And that gives them not only some valuable time, but it also develops some type of camaraderie with the sink right now.
Himes is in motion. Brissett hit as he throws, but he completes to Greenwich, reaching towards the pylon, and he's brought down just shy of the end zone. David Greenwich tied for the team lead in touchdown receptions last year on a 15-yard pickup, nearly had another.
Greenwich gets open because the defender's going to slip again. Pressure comes on a little blitz to the outside. Plenty of time, but you saw a moment ago, couldn't see it on that replay. The defender falls down. Greenwich, super hand, stretches out. Brown can't cause a fumble ball inside the one.
LaMarcus Farmer, the senior transfer from UAB, preventing what was surely a touchdown for David Greenwich. Farmer, one of the transfers from UAB after they discontinued the program. Timeout on the field here. This might be an injury timeout after Jacoby Brissett got popped on that last play. 5 for 5 on the day for Brissett. If you take another look at this,
Justin Lucas, 13, gets a piece of Brissett as he releases the football.
Well, Brissett will be taken out of the game. That might be just concussion protocol. So this will be Jalen McClendon, a redshirt freshman, one of the better quarterback recruits in his class.
That is their first timeout of the first half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
Dave Doran calls timeout. I think that is more procedural than anything else. If Brissett is being tended to, he's got to come out of the game.
Well, no one's talking to him. Take a look at the end of the play, and I think he just got the wind knocked out of him, to be very honest with you. We'll get a report in a few moments. Greenwich, such a strong guy at 6'5", 265. You try to take him head on, you're not going to win that too much. LaMarcus Farmer found that out.
So Brissett, hearing that he'll be back in action.
I think he's maybe got the wind knocked out of him.
Dave Doran has said as he's back in.
Yeah, well, he took a timeout, so they gave him the opportunity to get back in the game. And as valuable as he is for this football team, certainly if you thought it was concussion or something more serious, there's been a lot of people around him other than just that. So, yeah, that's good. That's a good sign to see him back in the game.
It's all protocol. Seventh play of the drive for NC State. Man in motion in the slot. Touchdown, North Carolina State. Breaking through is Matt Days. First touchdown of the season for the junior Matt Days.
Days got him down here. Days gets him in. Nice block at the point of attack. Power, strength, touchdown pack.
My Matt Days was the key to that drive, no doubt. 8 plays, 75 yards, and Kyle Bambard makes it a 14-7 lead for the Pack. Matt Days only one of 3 players in the country with more than 300 yards rushing, receiving, and in kick returns. Only 3 minutes and 21 seconds for the Wolfpack.
Alex Barr, 71, does a great job kicking out. Schooley, the center. Seal. Tony Adams, the sophomore out of Charlotte, does a nice job leading the way. And Matt Days, 8 touchdowns last year, his first of this season.
Well, if they keep this up, might have a high-scoring game here. Scores on 3 of the first 4 drives.
Now let's see on this drive what adjustments. You think he's not loose? You think Johnson isn't ready to play?
Busting out a few moves.
We'll see what adjustments the NC State defensive staff will make then. Then they've seen 2 possessions out of Troy. Get kind of a rhythm they're trying to have. offensively. But they've done a nice job, Troy, of throwing to the secondary receiver and using their speed. You saw a big catch a moment ago by Hall. We'll see what happens here.
Teddy Rubin lets it bounce out of the end zone for a touchback. NC State a lot to be happy about. 2 for 2 on scoring drives here. But Troy, after, again, a 3-and-out on their first possession, Brandon Silvers got back to work on that last series, and he's 3 for 3 on the day. Question is for Silvers, can he keep up that pace? Especially with a head coach, Neil Brown, that likes a gunslinging quarterback. On first down, John Johnson with a completion, and he rumbles forward for 7. Earlier today, a bit of tragedy at Troy University. Doug Hawkins, nicknamed Dr. Doug, one of the board of trustees at Troy University, passed away, and they quickly made decals to honor him on the right side of the helmets, honoring Dr. Doug. This Troy State, or this Troy Trojans team, playing with heavy hearts. 2nd and short for Silvers. Fumble, ball on the ground. And Troy may be lucky here. Not a clean handoff to Brandon Burks, and the Trojans escape with a play right back at the line of scrimmage.
This is a team that didn't turn the ball off in last year, but it's not a good connection between Silvers and Burke. Very fortunate for Troy that they're able to recover this. Burke falls on his own ball, but now you've got that third down situation.
Only converted on 39% of their third downs last year. 3rd and 5
three
from their own 30.
Three receivers to the top of the screen for Troy. Keep your eye on 18 Holmes.
Silvers releasing quickly, and he can't haul it in. John Johnson nearly with an acrobatic catch, but just a skosh beyond the line.
Well, he tried a little back shoulder fade. You've got man coverage to the outside with John Johnson. Johnson does a great job of catching, but you can literally see that he's not inbound. He catches Justin Burris on the coverage. One of the strengths of this NC State football team, they talk about the defensive backs, Jones, Burris, Toko, are all guys that are very active and can make plays.
Motion up front. And a flag comes in.
Before the snap, all start offense, number 14. 5-yard penalty, still 4th down.
That'll back up Troy a bit more. Gave that to Nick Young, wide receiver. Pretty good punt for Ryan Kay, and a fair catch signaled back of the NC State 30. 45-yard punt for Ryan Kay. This Troy team, Stan, get the sense you've seen their capabilities on offense, but those little mistakes. That in a game like
yeah, and this is a team, you know, and you only have the numbers from last season, but they weren't a very high penalty team. I think they only had like 4 games last year where they had more than 8 penalties. So they've got 3 right now, and though they're not big penalties, they've taken them out of some rhythm. They made that 3rd down a little long a moment ago. Now the question is, can the defense step up and make a stop? Get a 3-and-out, let that offense get back on the field.
Troy started the season just 1-8. Off the play fake. Completion to the near sideline, and Jalen Samuels pirouettes out of bounds. Only a couple picked up on the reception.
Excellent fakes. You've got an opportunity to make a play fake, hold the ball for a second, very relaxed, very casual, and then he was looking deep, no one open, goes to a secondary receiver. Samuels does a nice job to pick up a couple of yards.
Here's Deez tumbling forward to pick up a couple. Right, Jacoby Brissett, anything that we hear about Brissett, about him being a somewhat quiet leader, but having that swagger, being a man on a mission, as Dave Doran has said. He commands this offense very, very well.
He's doing two-a-days by himself this summer, working out with his offensive linemen, working out with his receivers, running, lifting, doing all the things that you have to do to have a great senior season.
Third and four. Brissett looking to the near sideline. Then the catch is made by Braylon Cherry. His first catch of the day, and he goes past midfield into Troy territory. 19-yard pickup for Braylon Cherry, the junior.
They just keep throwing him out there in waves, wide receivers. We've talked about Greenwich. We talk about now Cherry, an excellent athlete. Samuels has had a couple of catches. A guy that can make plays in the open field. Had five catches last year against Louisville for 51 and a touchdown. Potential guy.
Looks like they'll run down the clock to end the first quarter. NC State has been surgical offensively. Lead by a score here in Raleigh. First, it's Samuels. Troy with a response. NC State leads. You're watching the ACC on ESPN. NC State leads Troy 14-7 at Carter-Finley Stadium. Alex Faust here with you. Coach Neil Brown for the Troy Trojans. One of the youngest coaches in the nation. Second youngest to T.J. Flagg of Western Michigan. And for Neil Brown, we were talking to him on the phone earlier this week. As here's Brissett off first down, trying to find some room, spinning forward. And close to the first down marker, 8-yard pickup for Brissett. But Neil Brown, one of the younger coaches in the country, and has a bit of a bravado around him.
If that means swagger, yeah, he does. Yes. If that's what that means, because he's a guy that.
On second down, here's Brissett near the near sideline.
Yeah, you talk to him and he exudes confidence, and well, he should. He's had a great career. He was an assistant coach for many years at Troy, was also the OC at Kentucky. It feels like he's that new blood that Troy will take and take it to another level. Larry Blakeney, the legendary coach there. He said he wasn't trying to fill his shoes, but just come in with some new ideas to keep the Troy tradition rolling.
Matt Day's on the pickup, or a loss rather, of 1 yard. And now here's Brissett in the shotgun. Hand off to Hines, going nowhere. And Naheem Hines stopped at the line of scrimmage. Rashad Dillard on the stop for the Trojans.
Fly sweep again and take an eye there. Great job of pursuit by the Troy defense. About Dillard, one of the outstanding tacklers. It looks like they're going to try to go for this. You know, at this point in the game, this position, I think that's a great call by Coach Doran.
They've done this once before already today.
Fortunately, a little long three.
Brissett got a completion to the far sideline. Matt Days, who's done it all for NC State today, moves the sticks.
Six different NC State players have caught passes today. They're spreading the wealth. We talked about the versatility of Days. Had him flanked outside, lost his footing. Could have been a bigger play there. You look at Vigoni, and he's had a lot of success. And we'll talk about the coordinator at Troy, who used to be at the University of North Carolina. He's had some success against North Carolina State. Couldn't dial up the right defense then.
Second stint with the Trojans as well, Vic Koenig. On first down, Brissett, the handoff. Lots of space once again for Matt Days. Check that. That's to Quay Nichols, his first carry of the day. The true freshman moving up the depth chart in his sophomore year.
Oh, they love this young man, DeQuay Nichols. You've seen a lot of pounding ground from Days. This time we come with the 5'9 scatterbug.
13-yard pickup as they try to go tempo here on first down, but nothing doing. Nichols pushed back at the line of scrimmage.
Vic Coney, coached as a defensive coordinator now here at Troy. Last year, lost as the head coordinator at North Carolina, 35-7 against State. But the prior 2 years, the Tar Heels were able to beat NC State, and he had some success while he was the defensive coordinator back in 2005-08 while it was at Clemson. So he understands, even though it's different personnel, different coaches, he understands the mindset of North Carolina State football to a bit, especially from last year.
This is Nichols again. And this time Nichols a bit more success carving through. Quay Nichols took over kick return duties in his final four games of the year as we take another look at Vic Koenig. His third season at Troy overall after a stint in the early portion of the last decade. Now third and four for NC State. The 11th play of the drive in what's been another methodical march downfield.
Bunch set to the top of your screen. Man at the bottom.
Complete near sideline. Jermichael Ramos. The ball comes loose after the fact, but Ramos had the catch.
You love the versatility of this offense. You go away from the strong set, a perfect pass. Ramos, another one of these young, outstanding receivers. Only had a catch last season early against Boston College, but very strong at 6'2", climbs the ladder, gets that pass from Brissett, and inside the five once again.
10-yard pickup and up for a first down, and short yardage to go for the Wolfpack. Brissett with the handoff. Samuels reaching the pylon. Touchdown, NC State.
This offensive line is on all cylinders right now. All you need is a little space, and these running backs can do a great job. Samuels gets in the end zone, dives in, gets the touchdown. But again, he can't talk enough about the surge of the offensive line and the speed of the running backs for North Carolina State.
Averaged nearly 10 yards per carry last year, and he has two of the three NC State scores. Extra point is good for the Wolfpack. Jalen Samuels with his second rushing touchdown of the evening. It's been easy work of it for the Wolfpack offense by 14. Two rushing touchdowns for Jalen Samuels. NC State's the 14-point lead over the Troy Trojans. Once they get down to that red zone, Stan, it's been just so effortless for the Wolfpack.
Well, they've got a lot of weapons. I mean, you think about on that drive alone, Ramos touched the football. Cherry makes a big catch. We talk about Nichols. We talk about Days. He doesn't really do much on that drive because Samuels led the lead. So they've got a lot of versatility, a lot of weapons that'll bode well for them as this season goes on.
Troy will let this bounce out of the back of the end zone. Trojans take over. They've got a 14-point hole to dig out of here at Carter-Finley Stadium. Trojans with the football, trailing 21-7 in Raleigh, North Carolina. Alex Faust-Standluter here with you. Troy Trojans, 3 and out on two of their first three series of the ballgame. The other, a surgical drive downfield. Surely hoping for more of the latter. Brandon Silver's on first down, looking the sideline, and he's got his man there. That's Brian Holmes, a senior out of Florida.
If you're Troy right now, settle down. Okay, this isn't shocking you. NC State got on the road. And what you've got to do is execute your offense. The short passing game has been very effective for them. Let your wide receivers get out in space, make some plays, keep the chains moving, continue to give Silver some confidence.
Well, so short plays where he's seemed to be on a roll. Did a lot of that last season in his freshman campaign. On second down, nowhere to go in the backfield for Jordan Chun.
Well, we had talked a lot about these defensive linemen early in the game, but this time, Demaris Bryant just comes in there, makes the play, almost makes the tackle before Chun can get the football.
Andreas Bryant, the freshman. A lot of good things depth-wise for this NC State team defensively. And now a third and long for the Trojans. Silvers gets rid of it, and it's broken up. Well covered along the sideline by Mike Stevens, the sophomore.
Nice throw. You see the strength in the arm of Silver to throw across the numbers. Bentley not able to make that play. And the problem with a team that runs a fast tempo or a quick tempo offense, if you're not able to get some first downs and keep things going, you put your defense now back at a disadvantage. You're going to be back out on the field in less than a minute.
There's Ryan Kay, who was both the punter and the place kicker last year. Now only has to do one of the two. This punt will cross midfield, go out near the NC State 35. So far, so good defensively for NC State. This was the type of execution they were looking for. They have a lot of frequent substitutions on this defensive line, and so far they have held Troy to very few options.
And Bryant makes that play, cause a reason. We haven't even talked about Mike Rose, the outstanding defensive end that we're looking for, nor B.J. Hill. And these guys, along with Contavious Street, who moved from the outside to the inside this year. Second unit guys coming in, making some plays.
And that's so encouraging for Dave Doran, truly. Jacoby Brissett back to work. Dropping back to pass. And he'll complete it short to the near sideline. Jonathan Alston trying to get back to the line of scrimmage. Don't think he did so. Alston, the junior out of North Carolina. Tackle made in backfield by Callaway for Troy University. And in motion is Hines. An inside handoff to Days, picks up a couple. And for NC State, Stan, you'd have to think they're fairly content to run the ball. They've controlled things on the ground.
Yeah, that's kind of MO, especially the last part of the season, the last five games when they went 4-1, they averaged about 245 yards on the ground. So they're not afraid to, and they play, as you said earlier, what's successful for them. So here we go. 97 yards already they picked up on the ground. A huge third down, I think, if you're Troy. Must get a stop.
Samuels finds Days. Troy's been unable to stop him no matter what he's doing, catching or running.
He had 32 receptions last year. His ability to step outside, just a quick little out route. He needed 7 yards. He'll give you 13 or 14, 15 actually. And he's got great hands, and the ability to get him in open spaces is just one of the things that makes him such a dangerous player. Was the NC State Offensive Player of the Year last year.
Here's Days on the handoff, bouncing to the outside. And a pickup of 5 for Matt Days. Now you understand why he's one of the top running backs in the ACC last year.
You see him fake that sweep real quick to Hines. Hines, a track star when he was at Garner High School. His sister, his twin sister, also runs track here at NC State. So he's got speed. So that's something that Matt Canada's kind of keeping in the back of the playbook. May see that later on in the game, the quick sweep to Naheem Hines.
And that just adds to what was one of the better backfields in the ACC last year. This, keep in mind, without Shadrack Thornton, suspended for a couple games for violation of team rules. On second down, Brissett rolling out. And he's got Samuels pushed back.
being hit that time by the safety, Demetrius Kane. Read the naked boot. Keep your eyes on number 21. Reads, recognizes, responds. Kane's one of those mini transfers.
Backward.
One of the many transfers on this Troy football team, played at East Mississippi Community College. Really excited about he can do what he's going to bring to this team on the defensive side, along with John Marshall.
There's another third down situation, Stan. Brissett, plenty of time. Got nowhere to go up the middle, though. All his receivers were covered downfield. Much better work in the secondary from the Trojans, and it might force a punt.
Super job by the backs. No way to throw the football. Brissett decides to run the ball. Remember, he ran for over 500 yards last season. William Lloyd comes from his outside backer spot to make the big hit to force NC State into their first punt of the evening.
Brian Holmes back to receive off this boot from Jackson Maples. Fair catch signaled at the 15. First time that NC State has been forced to punt this evening. Wolfpack lead at 21-7 on the Trojans. Troy Trojans with the ball, trailing by two scores. Carter-Finley Stadium. And Brandon Silver's back to work. Finally got a stop defensively. See what they could do with it with the football. Pass complete to the near sideline here off first down. If they can get those short passes going, that'd be good, because so far the drives have been short-lived.
That's one of the first times a day we've seen them get a first down or pick up positive yards of over first down. Remember, Coach Brown said we've got to do something on first down.
Connor Brevard on the catch and a handoff on the subsequent first down. A couple of yards for Brandon Burks. But that's what they did on that scoring drive earlier, Stan, is they were able to mix it up. Last two possessions for Troy, just six plays and two net yards.
Are you able to get more than 5 yards on first down? It makes your second down call so much easier here at NC State. I mean, and eight.
Burks slipping through a tackle to create a third and short.
This is a manageable third down, and we talked earlier about North Carolina State and their ability to convert on third down. Last season, Troy was 39% on third down percentage. This is their fifth time, I think, that they've been in a third down situation. Very big for them to, and their confidence to convert in this third down at four.
Burks in the backfield, he gets the call, and he might have enough.
We need to get to the 35.
And they'll give it to him.
I like Brandon Burks' ability to pound and pound in between the tackles. Has led this Troy Trojan team the last two seasons in rushing. Last year over 500 yards, nearly 600 yards, and three touchdowns. So they go to him often, and I'll give credit too. Also, we talked about the offensive line of North Carolina State. You know, Luke Lawrence, the center, number 71, and then also Crumity, number 57, that freshman. They've done a nice job in holding up, withstanding, even though they're not picking up big chunks yards, they're not pressured.
Silver's this time on the pitch to Burks. Well read by the Pack defense. Jared Fernandez, number four in scarlet, coming in for the stop.
Hadn't talked to Fernandez, but keep your eye on number four. Again, reading it, recognizing, makes a play. He comes up there along with my man Mike Rose in there making plays. The defense of North Carolina State, I think, is going to be a. They were good last year. They're going to be even better this year.
That's Dravius Wright. Get a portion of that tackle as well. Second and long for the Trojans. Five receivers set. Quick slant route. Rubin unable to haul it in. Bounced on the turf before he could get underneath it. And even with Rubin and his small frame, one of the smallest players on the field for Troy, couldn't haul it in.
They played Teddy Rubin out of the H-back position. Ball was low. Probably a catchable ball. It was low and away where it needs to be between the backer and the defensive back. Rubin unable to make that play. Another third down conversion situation for the Trojans.
Silver swings it to the outside. Holmes scampers to the sideline, but just short of the first down marker. And now a decision for Neil Brown.
That was short, but a nice on the screen there. A nice block by KD Aidenfield. You want your wide receivers to be able to block downfield. Troy's going to have to punt this, I think. You know, you don't want to take this big risk. 4 from 4, 3:40 left to play.
You're going to go for it. Neil Brown wants to be cavalier in this game. Now they bring on the unit.
That's a high risk. I like your guts, but that's a high risk play.
I think Neil Brown wants to be cavalier, not foolish.
Later in the ball game, 4 from 3, 4 from 4, maybe not now.
Sherry, a nice punt, calls for the fair catch at the 9. Troy once again stymied offensively. Wolfpack lead by a pair of scores.
The reason I say that is because he does it with his own money. But you know what? He ain't got to do it with his own money.
All that commotion was for Nicholas Lacey, a walk-on, a sophomore. One of the great cornerbacks on this team and earned himself a scholarship. Gave it away during a team meeting. And for players who work so hard on their own dime to earn that scholarship, it's a special one.
Oh, it is. Out in Pinecrest High School. And you know, he's really was excited about that. The team was. They were ecstatic about that.
Brissett gets rid of this on first down. Good coverage downfield again from the Trojans. Now they've got NC State backed up here after a 54-yard punt. Or 49-yard punt, rather. The first incompletion of the day for Jacoby Brissett. Both he and Lacey wearing number 12 on this team.
You don't want to give up the big play if you're Troy right now. You got NC State pinned in your end zone, 2nd and 10. Try to make a solid play. Make them punch. You've got timeouts. Get a score on the board before the half.
Give to Days. Breaks 2 tackles. Days across the 20. They have not found a way to shut him down.
Well, there goes that theory. Days, 14 carries for 64 yards. Offensive line does a great job getting off the ball. And all you've got to do is give Matt Days just a little room. He'll run to daylight.
Another first down for NC State. Present to Days again. This time wrapped up along the outside. Jamal Statham, sophomore on the tackle. For Troy, Stan, you get the sense they're going to need a stop here before halftime. NC State will receive to begin the second half.
It would be huge for them to get a stop. Yeah, stopping the score would be great. But this North Carolina State offense that rushed for over 200 yards, most yards they rushed for since 1992, looks like they're continuing that same pace so far.
Lots of time for Brissett. He'll dump it off. Number 21, Matt Days again.
Who else?
14-yard pickup and a first down for Matt Days.
Ways you know your offensive line is doing a great job when the quarterback's uniform isn't dirty and when he's got an opportunity to survey the entire field. Brissett looked deep, had an outlet there, and Days wide open on his right side, picks up 12, 13 yards, moves the chains, and is having a heck of a first half.
Now it's Nichols on the handoff, and Nichols breaks through. Gain of 8.
See how Nick was attacked the hole right there.
Ruddock, who we called his name earlier with the face mask there, comes in, tries to make the big hit, but just too strong that time by DeQuay Nichols.
On second down, Brissett looking over the middle. It's complete once again. Late flag coming in, possibly a late hit. Gavin Locklear, the sophomore, on the reception, a 15-yard gain, but we'll see what the penalty marker is all about.
When you talk about a success story, Gavin Locklear, a guy from locally here right at Apex, right down the street from North Carolina State, broke his leg, sat out the entire season, also a walk-on, getting some action, and does a great job, a little in route. And Brissett, who has been so accurate last year,
after the play, personal foul, late hit on the defense, number 26. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, automatic first down.
Fourth penalty for the Trojans. 40 yards from the penalty markers today.
Get Michael Rowland. Look and see, maybe he led with his hands, but nevertheless.
On replay, it didn't look as bad as
it did not.
Was, yeah. Here's Brissett complete to Cherry, fighting for a couple more yards, close to the first down marker, and he's inside the red zone. 9-yard pickup for Braylon Cherry. And Lonnie Gosha on the tackle. NC State picking up the pace here. Second and one. Days stumbling past the marker. He'll have a first down. It's been a challenge for Vic Koenig's bunch. No huddle for NC State, and we'll have a whistle. Clock stops at 32 seconds left after Brissett spikes it. Not wanting to use a timeout here. They still have two remaining.
You gotta think, with good clock management, that they could run two, maybe three plays. I don't think they're thinking field goal right now.
Especially given how surgical Matt Days has been. All right, second and 10. 32 seconds left in the first half. NC State trying to break this open to a three-score game. Brissett looking to the end zone. Caught! Touchdown, NC State! Jermichael Ramos with a 14-yard touchdown reception. And it's a three-score game.
This was just a little bit of a basketball play here. You get inside position, I'll throw it up, you catch it. Ramos goes up, catches, touchdown, NC State. Not a lot you could do. Montrez Kitchens, the all-conference safety for Troy, unable to make the play there.
Haven't called his name much today. Kyle Bambard makes it a 28-point lead for the Pack. First career touchdown for Jermichael Ramos.
Let's take a look at Ramos there in the slot. Just comes down, makes a little in route, gets inside position on Kitchens. Kitchens trying to defend to the outside. Ramos almost mistimed his jump at 6'2", but nevertheless, perfect. Again, protection, protection, protection. Quarterback has a lot of time. Ramos, a good athlete, makes a good play.
Talking with Matt Canada the other day, Stan mentioned that Ramos playing some of the best football in his collegiate career. Had a great camp, playing at a high level, getting rewarded with his first touchdown grab. ...28 seconds remaining. And keep in mind, NC State will have the ball to begin the second half. So for Troy, certainly an urgency here. Teddy Rubin wearing number 7 in white. Back to take this kick from Jackson Maples. Short of the end zone, here is Rubin. Looking to the outside, Rubin tackled quickly. DeQuay Nichols on the stop.
It's amazing how making a few plays becomes contagious for the whole team. You get a drive, you get a touchdown just before the half. DeQuay Nichols comes out of there. We've called his name on offense. Now making a big hit on special teams.
21 seconds left in the half, and I'd be surprised if Troy does anything cavalier here. Brandon Silver's on first down. They'll keep it on the ground. Bouncing to the outside. This is Brandon Burks getting to midfield. And a flag comes in late. Two of them. Seconds left in the half, and we'll check the penalty marker here. Yard pickup.
At the end of the run, personal foul, face mask on the defense, 15-yard penalty on the end of the run, automatic first down.
Wow.
Look at the explosion. We talked about the young freshman from out. He does a great job, 57. He seals, holds his block, get a block from the outside from one of the wide receivers, and we've talked about the speed and also the strength of Brandon Burks. 31-yard pickup plus 15 more. Troy still got a shot at this.
12 seconds. You could take a shot or two. Silvers looking over the middle. Near sideline. It's caught. Brian Holmes. Touchdown, Trojans. 37-yard score for Brian Holmes, who's slow to get up. And that's not a good sign for the Trojans. He may have across the pylon, but the end result requires the training staff.
Take a look. We'll see this in a second. But Brandon Silver sits up strong in the pocket and throws a dart. You wonder why he only had a few interceptions last year. A perfectly placed ball. Does he get in? Yes. And at the end of the play, you take a look at Holmes, and you can see that Holmes' knee is bent in a way that it probably shouldn't go.
He had caught in there, yeah, in his ankle, yeah, and his knee.
Brian Holmes, who had 34 catches last season, 5 touchdowns, a huge pass, gives the Trojans a little momentum at the end of the thing. But right now, I think all Trojan fans are holding their hearts and concerned about young Mr. Brian Holmes.
Big Play Brian is his nickname, and that's a big one. 4 catches, 84 yards now on the day. And a critical score here, but obvious concern for one of their star wide receivers. 13th career touchdown catch for Brian Holmes. And with one tick on the clock, Troy has eaten into the NC State lead. That's the explosiveness that this Troy team has. And talking to Neil Brown, a couple things they needed: defensive stops and explosive plays. Those are the two things he said. If we're going to have a chance at this game, we need those two. And they've gotten one, but at what cost? 31-yard run, 15-yard penalty, and then a 37-yard touchdown pass from Brandon Silvers. Extra point pending, and Jared Solomon can make this a 14-point game. Or 20 seconds to go, 82 yards. He's got it. 1 second on the clock, and Troy with an explosive drive to get within a couple scores.
We talked a moment ago about Doc Watt's big hit to start this play, this series, and how contagious a big play like they could be. I'm going to tell you what, they're down 14, yes, when they get in a half, but there's going to be a lot of enthusiasm there by the Troy team as they go in a half, because they feel like, hey, guys, we still got some bullets in the chamber. We can still make some plays here.
Perhaps tempered to a certain degree by the injury to Brian Holmes. Over the last two seasons, Holmes has more catches for 30-plus yards than any other player in the Sun Belt. Back-to-back all-conference selection. For Neil Brown and this bunch, this is manageable. 14-point game, assuming nothing happens here on this kickoff.
Script this, you let it bounce a couple of times. Let's go into the house.
Good settlement.
Don't want to give any chance for something crazy to happen here. Jared Solomon kicking it deep. And here is Hines from the five. Hines past midfield. And he's ankle tackled before further damage can be done. Troy Trojans have made this a ball game after an explosive play. Brian Holmes hauling in his 13th career touchdown to make it a 14-point game at the half. NC State extended the lead early. Troy has a response in him. We'll come back with a half after this. Welcome back to the Capital One Halftime Report as you take a look at the Wendell Murphy Football Center here on the campus of NC State. Beautiful building, got a museum inside, and of course featuring a lot of the quarterbacks that have come through this program. They call it QB University for a reason. Russell Wilson, Philip Rivers among the many. Couple of upcoming games here on the ESPN family of networks, and a great early season slate starting Monday night. Ohio State, Virginia Tech. A lot of folks, Stan, think the Buckeyes might be a bit vulnerable early on.
Ohio State coming up to Blacksburg will be rocking and rolling on the mountain, trying to get revenge from their only loss last season. But we know that Frank Beamer's team, a team the last couple of seasons hasn't had Virginia Tech football, will be ready, willing, and able to knock off the number one team and the defending champion in the Buckeyes of Ohio State.
A lot of NC State fans will be looking at that Clemson-Louisville game as well. Louisville, an early season test for NC State coming up in a couple of weeks. And taking a look at the upcoming schedules for both of these teams as well. The Troy Trojans, boy, they are running the gauntlet in the early going. Of course, NC State today. You've got Wisconsin coming up. You've got Mississippi State in there as well. And with a new coaching staff, it's going to be a lot of work to get things settled for the new year.
Well, as we're seeing today, this game is a challenge. And certainly you look down that schedule. So the Mississippi, a bowl team last year, as well as Alabama State. Don't forget about Appalachian State and Georgia Southern. Two teams that were bowl eligible had they been eligible in their respective conference. It's going to be a very interesting season for the Troy Trojans.
NC State, meanwhile, kind of easing into ACC play, but that first game to really circle, October 3rd against Louisville, that'll be a big litmus test for the Wolfpack.
Well, they can't go to sleep against Old Dominion up in Norfolk or the South Alabama game, as I mentioned, the bowl team last year. But that Louisville game, everybody in Raleigh talking about that, such a close matchup last season. Look down the NC State schedule, the always Virginia Tech game, always tough. They haven't had a lot of success in Raleigh against a team in Wake Forest that I think is going to be a better football team. Clemson, always a big game. The Boston College, Florida State, always another one of those state versus state. Mm-hmm. And we know that they almost knocked them off last year here at Carter-Finley. And then Syracuse in a traditional rivalry game against the Tar Heels. A
couple of marquee games on the NC State schedule this year. NC State and Troy will have the second half coming up. A lot of new, neat facilities here on the campus of NC State. Second half coming your way next. A 14-point lead for the Wolfpack over the Troy Trojans here at Carter-Finley Stadium. Alex Faust, Stan Luter here with you. That was a first half that was unexpectedly explosive. Both of these teams connecting for scores at a pretty rapid clip, but NC State got the sense kind of determined the tempo earlier.
I like NC State. Anytime a team can have balance, running and passing, and to disperse the ball among a lot of players, it keeps players happy, they play harder, and obviously you're getting a lot of production by a lot of guys today for NC State.
Well, NC State connected on a couple of scores early on here, and actually wound up being a 7-7 game. Well, you thought this might be back and forth.
It's back and forth. There's a play that gets everything started with Samuels, and again, we talked about the great offensive line. After a big pass play for Troy, they barrel in there.
Jordan Chun, one of the better running backs for this Troy team, scores in his 7-7. But back comes NC State, blocking the point of attack. Get in the end zone. That's what I want to do. Matt Days. How many times are we going to call Matt Days' name today? Several, because he does a lot of things. Great run inside here. Samuels goes in for his touchdown. NC State playing solid defense and even better offense. Just before the half is over, a nice catch to Ramos for a touchdown from 14 yards out and a two-play drive. Big-time catch by Holmes. He's caught four passes today. That's a huge one. Puts Troy on the board one more time.
Hopefully he's able to come back as well after tweaking his knee. Two-score game in Raleigh. Back for the second half after this. You're watching the ACC on ESPN, our first week of the 2015 season. We've got a good one here in Raleigh. NC State 28, Troy 14 as we get set for the second half. A lot of the numbers, Stan Luter, will be in NC State's favor, rightfully so. But for Troy, they got what they wanted. They got a couple stops late, and they got that explosive play towards the end of that first half.
25 plays for Troy for 180 yards in total offense. North Carolina State, 44 plays, 281. But the ability to bounce back after a touchdown by NC State, I give Troy a lot of credit. This is a very important drive for momentum on both sides of the football.
NC State will have the ball to start the second half. Jared Solomon set to go. And away we go in the second. Naheem Hines, 2 yards deep. Hines brings it up the middle. Swarmed by white jerseys, and Niles Clark wraps him up at the 20. Well, Jacoby Brissett, you've gotten what you've wanted out of him if you're NC State. Accuracy, only one incompletion in that first half. He's had a couple of different targets to go to as well. First down of the 22. Handoff and a bounce to the outside. Easy work of it for Jalen Samuels as he scampers out of bounds. 18-yard pickup. Matt Day's got a lot of work in the first half. Jalen Samuels has a couple of TDs. First down for the Wolfpack. Have to get the sense that those big plays ripping open the secondary have to come to a stop soon. If you're Troy. Matt Day's back into the ballgame. Brissett dodging tacklers. Can't get past this one. He'll be brought down for a loss. At least three different hands in there for Troy. And it brings up second down.
A few times where they've really been able to get to Brissett. And you have to bring him down. Notice there's about four guys there on the play trying to bring this guy down. He's an outstanding runner, 500 yards plus in running the football. Sets up a third down. Good solid tackle by a guy we haven't talked a lot about today in Tyler Roberts. And many feel that he may be the best player pound for pound on this Troy Trojan football team.
Give half the credit there, too, to Demetrius Kane, 21. Second and long, Brissett. Not a lot of room to work with. And a better look defensively from Troy. Montrese Kitchens, haven't called his name all that much. First team preseason all Sunbelt. Kitchens comes up with a stop.
Kitchens did a nice job that time and playing from his free safety spot, seeing the little quick inside screen was coming. Was able to come up and close on that play and set up a third down for NC State.
Third and long here. It's be good for Troy. They can get off the field rather quickly. Coming off of that score to end the first half.
NC State's had a lot of success with the bunch set.
Brissett, tons of time. But he has no receivers to look to. And Brissett will be short of the first down. Well covered downfield, and DeQuadrian Lewis comes in for the tackle. It'll be a punt for the Wolfpack.
They had five wide receivers in the set. So your front four guys and linebackers have had to play smart and a good job that time holding him to only 4 yards, an open field tackle. Your Coach Brown, you got to be happy with that first possession.
Fair catch called at the 7-yard line. Vic Koning's got to be happy coming out of the break with a big stop. NC State can't get past midfield. Troy will have the ball when we return. NC State up by 14 over Troy, but a good defensive stop for the Trojans that last sequence. And Brandon Silvers gets a chance to go back to work. Oh, he's backed up beyond his own 10-yard line. What a drive to score at the end of the first half, going 82 yards in 20 seconds.
But the way he executes the offense, short passing game, being backed up doesn't bother him quite as much as some quarterbacks may.
High snap, and here's Andre Flakes, his first touch of the ball game. Gets to the outside, but can't find a crease out there. Second and 8.
We've talked a lot about the versatility of the NC State offense. Troy has several weapons as well. We've seen what Holmes can do and Burks, but this kid Flakes is a guy that can really run.
Off the fake, they keep it to the inside again.
We talked about this a lot early in the game, moving the chains for Troy. 1 out of 5 in third down conversions in the first half. Faced with their first big third down challenge in the second half. They expect to win this football game. They've got to do a couple things. One, they've got to move that ball on first down, make some plays, and they've got to get some sustained drives. Even though they had the big play just before the half, they've got to try to keep the NC State offense off the field, wear down the defense a little bit.
Brandon Burks in the backfield. Silvers back to pass. Got a screen to Burks, and he's ripped down. Nowhere close to the first down marker. It'll be a 3 and out for the Trojans. Josh Jones on the stop for NC State.
Slow developing play on the screen pass. Burks, usually a very dependable receiver when he gets the ball in the open field, but Josh Jones has made a better play in making the tackle. Jones led this NC State team last year in interceptions. That time came up with a big hit, was one of the tackle leads for the Wolfpack as well.
This is Ryan Kay, very short punt, got it off the outside of his foot, and it'll be out at the 30-yard line. And that's a poor mistake from Ryan Kay. 16-yard punt, NC State set up in great field position here. Up by 14 over the Troy Trojans in Raleigh. State Wolfpack sitting pretty, up by a couple of scores, and after a 3 and out from Troy and a 19-yard punt, they are set up well into Troy territory here. And Jacoby Brissett back to work.
But what do you think we'll see? Unless they go with an explosion play immediately, we think we see a lot of days on this drive.
Got Samuels in as well. Brissett rolling right, and he's got Samuels along the right sideline. Don't believe there was a gain on the play.
Good job by Josh Marshall coming up in from this cornerback space. Adrian Lewis also from the safety spot. Red Dead held about 2-3 yards on the play. He's kind of thinking maybe NC State would try to take that deep. But in a power set, one back, I think you're going to see Days.
They mark at 3 yards, 2nd and 7. And here is Days. Days with some space. Days! Nobody close! Touchdown, Wolfpack! 30 yards for Matt Days, 2nd score of the evening.
Well, it didn't take us long. Great block, comes back inside, cuts against the grain, put your foot in the dirt, turn, put the ball down and meet your teammates. Days once again with another outstanding run for NC State. Quick two-play drive.
Second touchdown of the night for Matt Days. And here is Kyle Bambor. 35-14 NC State. Ripping this game open in the opening minutes of the second half. Matt, Canada's got to be pleased. NC State has been surgical on offense. They've had a couple of different targets. And a quick drive to go up 35-14.
Everybody blocks to the inside, and you cut, bounce to the outside. No one really lays a hand on Mr. Mays. And Matt Canada is very interesting because he says, you know, it's almost like a roulette wheel. What do you want to dial up next when you've got balance and you've got a lot of weapons both on the outside as well as the inside? Makes for a lot of easy play calling afternoons and evenings.
To go out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Well, Matt Days, one of our impact players today. A couple of touchdowns for Matt Days, but it's all the things he's doing in between to kind of rip things open for NC State. Well,
the thing you like about Days is the versatility. And he can run inside between the tackles, he can get outside, and he can catch the football. When you think about that and say, wow, you put that into one package. And with all the other weapons that NC State has, what it does is when he gets the ball, he's making some positive plays.
He led the team in all-purpose yards last year. Brandon Burks, meanwhile, 52 yards for Burks. Troy has really yet to get the run game going. And here's Brandon Silvers on first down. Has a completion near the 35-yard line to Teddy Rubin.
And you like that play call on first down, influence to the right side. Burks, Silvers with very good footwork, comes back to his secondary receiver and makes a nice play. And Rubin gets, you know, a nice, good 8 yards, 9 yards on the play.
This is what NC State wouldn't want, to get Burks going. Quick completion again for Silvers.
Running a little bubble screen is trying, you know, again, making your first downs manageable, try to get to the outside route. Another nice catch that time, you know, by Salim.
Ismail Salim, his first catch of the ball game. First down for Troy. Here's Burks. Burks off to the races. Nobody's going to catch him. Touchdown, Troy. Brandon Burks, 57 yards.
You're watching two excellent coach football teams from an offensive perspective. You go outside, outside, loosen up the defense, and then you go inside, bounce to the out with the speedster Burks. And Burks gets into the end zone once again as well. And again, we talked about speed, we talk about power. We're seeing it out of Mays and also by Brandon Burks, the senior.
Brandon Burks, his first touchdown of the season. And Troy with a response back to a 14-point game. Brandon Burks, all Sunbelt honorable mention last year, and he's been the power running back that Troy's needed today.
Nice double block right out there. Luke Lawrence, we talked about the junior. Cromedy, 57, Boring, 62. Create a hole, and then once you get the hole, the guy knows how to fill it. Brandon Burks, who led this team in rushing a season ago, in fact, the last two seasons, well on his way again. An outstanding game, and we were about to say, as the impact player, the player before that, we're about to say, hey, don't forget the touchdown that led, the touchdown they got just before the half. Burks was very influential with the big run. Now over 100 yards himself for the ball game.
It's his sixth career 100-yard-plus game. At every turn, Troy seemingly has an answer. But now it's up to the defense once again. Dave Doran, perhaps a bit more of a nervy game from his defense than he would have expected. A couple of big plays, explosive plays Troy has found this evening.
Troy last year had 12 touchdowns and 20 yards or more already with two tonight.
To be taken deep in the end zone from Naheem Hines. NC State will start at the 25. And all of a sudden, the Wolfpack in need of a response. This has been a fun back and forth.
It really has. It really has. Because on paper, many people say, okay, Troy, you know much about them in the Sun Belt. They've had a history, a great tradition of football and winning and going to bowl games, you know, previous years. Haven't had the success they've wanted maybe the last three or four seasons, again, under the legendary Larry Blakeney, now a new regime. And I think if you're a Troy Trojan fan, you've got to be very optimistic about the future.
And you had a sense that Troy would increase its scoring total from last year with Neil Brown at the helm. Brissett launching downfield, just overthrown. Jermichael Ramos, step or two behind that.
Play fake, reverse to screen fight, and then just throw it as far as you actually can. Ramos not able to catch that. Nice job of coverage that time by the Troy defender.
And Jalen Roundtree, maybe a little bit of separation at the end, but stuck with him step for step. Matt Days, boy, when you need a play, dial him up. Demetrius Kane on the tackle. 6-yard run for Days, and now a 3rd and 4. Defense was the biggest issue for Troy last year. And again, an opportunity for a big third down stop. Brissett in the gun. He'll take off. Brissett's lunging towards the first down marker. He looks to be short. Vic Koenig not happy with something, but Brissett may be short of the first down.
I think he's about a yard and a half short. Better look again at Vic Koenig, defensive coordinator, had a stint at Clemson, and again had some success against North Carolina State and also at University of North Carolina. This is a fourth down and a short one. Gotta be disciplined right now for Troy.
Wolfpack going for it. Day's got it. Not much you can do.
It's a lot of confidence. You've got to be really confident in your offensive line. 4th and 1, deep in your territory. And not afraid to try to get the first down. You see Quentin Schooley, number 60.
And now NC State is 3 for 3 on 4th down. 23 first downs in the game. This will be a short gain here. Matt Days on the carry once again.
We were talking a moment ago, Alex, about this Troy defense that gave up a lot of points last year. They gave up 40 points or more. Gave up 66 down in Athens against Georgia. But they feel like they've got enough components in the puzzle now that the defense is going to get stronger. They've had some plays tonight.
Here's Days slipping past two tackles. And about 2 yards short of the first down.
I've been impressed at the way they've jumped around and been at the football. But sometimes this athletic ability takes over. And Matt Days shows a great example then. Getting good push off the football. A lot of running backs go down when they're hit like that. Days hit spins and is able to pick up an extra 2 or 3 yards.
Days having quite the evening. On 3rd down, Brissett brought down.
Stadium. Jamal Statham. 4 sacks on the season last year. Watch him get rid of a tackle defender there and says, hey, look, I'm going and I'm getting you down. A huge defensive play. Keep your eye on number 30 from the outside. Gets rid of the block right there. Keeps his feet and a huge tackle for the Trojans of Troy.
Loss of 7 and the 5th career sack for Jamal Statham, the sophomore. A very young defensive line for Troy. Good punt away here. And it'll take an NC State bounce by the 20. Finally touched at the 18. 43-yard punt, but that's a big, big sack from Jamal Statham. And Troy will have the ball here. This Trojans team is not going away, Stan.
Well, they talked about he's getting another look at Statham, 6'2", 200-pound junior. That he's been playing in practice with a very high level, playing very tough energy level. Got a brother that played at Troy a few years before and has really come along. That was a big-time play. We'll take a look at Sunbelt. Southern, always good no matter where they are. Now in the Sunbelt, Louisiana Lafayette, Arkansas State. The Mountaineers of Appalachian State taking on Clemson, I think, next week. And Texas State, who's taking on Florida State tonight. So very solid conference.
Illegal touching on the kicking team at the 22-yard line. First and 10 from that spot.
Okay, so they'll move it up 4 yards.
And next year, they'll welcome Coastal Carolina into the Sun Belt.
Yes, Chanticleers.
So that'll be a...
It'll be around 12 for the Sun Belt as well, which is so important for scheduling purposes. All right, here's Brandon Silvers on first down. Knocked down hard as helmet comes loose, and the ball is out as well. NC State has it on a thundering hit from Jared Fernandez.
Just go ahead and mark this one down. We don't even have to put this or tell anybody this is going to be in the highlight package. First thing is you hope Silver is okay. But just take a look at the impact of this play. Coming and going. Ball, helmet, dislodged. Ouch.
You hope Silvers is okay. That was a devastating hit.
Right, they call him from the nickel spot. Comes up and makes what I think is the play. Oh, my right. Goodness. Look out. Head. He didn't know which one to go after. The ball on a helmet when he made the hit. Nevertheless, NC State back in business.
Dravius Wright.
Dravius Wright, yeah.
Boy,
wow.
Fernandez was the one who came up with the ball. Dravius Wright, junior out of Florida, forced 2 fumbles last season and 11 starts. And
take a look. Ooh!
Yikes. What field position for the Wolfpack? First turnover for Troy in this game. And a first down for Brissett. Giving to Hines, nowhere to go. And he's pushed back for a loss of 4.
Yeah, that hit was so big that the crowd is still stunned. There's a buzz in the air right now at Carter-Finley Stadium. What a huge, big-time play by Dravius Wright.
I'm wondering if Brandon Silvers is okay. Looked shaken up quite a bit. Through no fault of Dravius Wright, came in there head of steam. And
oh, it was a clean hit. Hell yeah. No question about that.
Wow. Third and long. Brissett going to the end zone. Contact there and a flag. Clear penalty. Montrese Kitchens with the contact, but this will be moved up near the goal line. Here's Pat Garvin.
Pass interference on the defense number 1. I rule the ball will be spotted at the 2-yard line. First and goal from that spot.
Yeah, at the top of the screen. Kitchens gets caught. Easy call there.
led Troy in tackles last year, but not the one he wanted to make. Quick handoff on the restart of play, but no gain.
He asked his Troy defense to be able to come up and make another play. Robertson Statham with that big sack a moment ago, and you felt like Troy was getting some momentum, but Wright quickly took all that away as North Carolina State continues to knock on the door.
And those are those mistakes, Stan.
Well, that's that quick change turnover that you really can't avoid, you know, avoiding that play. There's no fault of Silver to get hit that hard.
Samuels, touchdown, Wolfpack. Third touchdown of the ball game for the sophomore Jalen Samuels.
Jalen Samuels is having a wonderful game. We've talked about Dave, but don't forget about this young man, Jalen Samuels.
Only had one touchdown all of last season and now has three tonight. NC State has doubled up the Troy Trojans.
Last season, NC State had 9 ball games when they had 3 touchdowns or more. They're picking up where they left off last season. Remember the name, Jalen Samuels.
Well, the turnover proves costly. And Brandon Silvers has his helmet back on. Appears he'll be back after a jarring hit from Travius Wright. Well, this is the start that NC State was looking for, a flying start offensively for Dave Doran's bunch. Former head coach at Northern Illinois, brought them to the Orange Bowl a couple years back, remember? Former finalist for National Coach of the Year. His third season at NC State.
I feel like they really turned the tide last year, midseason, winning 4 out of their last 5 ball games. The bowl game win, UCF. And they feel like, you know, things are really moving in the right direction at North Carolina State football-wise. Season ticket package sold out. Carter-Finley Stadium fast approaching next year, 50th anniversary. This complex, its entirety, they just opened up the indoor facility and is absolutely marvelous. And what they're doing here under the leadership of Athletic Director Debbie Al is fantastic. And North Carolina State is that team that, yeah, there's a lot of buzz about this team. As we said early in the game about the possibility of maybe winning that ACC championship, we're definitely contending for. You've seen a lot out of this Wolfpack team tonight.
NC State picked to finish 4th in the Atlantic this year. Here's the handoff to Burks. Slips through a tackler and gets out of bounds near the first down marker.
Gotta be impressed with the tenacity of this Troy team. You know, they've had some big plays go against them. They were down, and they keep trying to fight back and have some explosion plays of their own. Nice run that time by Burke.
Brandon Silvers back to work. They give him the first down. And again, it's Burke. Take a look at that preseason poll in the ACC. And NC State picked to finish 4th in the division. But there's a lot, especially with the way their schedule is set up, they can ease into conference play, and if they can pass that first test against Louisville, which will be here at home at Carter-Finley Stadium, there's a lot of hope that this Wolfpack team can make some big waves in the ACC this year. Burke is pushed back to the line of scrimmage.
One of the reasons they're very excited is about that young man right there, Brad Chubb. Got a brother that plays in Wake Forest, and we know of his cousin Nick, who's doing some damage down in Athens. And I'll tell you what, this defense, you look at Josh Jones, you've called his name a couple of times, Chubb, an outstanding young player. The thing they've got at NC State, they've also got depth and guys that are playing early and making contributions.
In and out of the hands of DeAndre Douglas. And Troy will be forced to punt.
Silver's remembering what happened to him the last time he went back to pass, got rid of that ball just a little quick and had a little too much mustard on it. Douglas unable to catch it.
Let's be Ryan Kay back to punt for the Trojans. A game that feels like it might be slipping away. Just under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Cherry from his own 15. Cherry still on his feet. Gets to the sideline. Has a blocker. May have stepped out. As he's past midfield and continues to rumble forward. Cherry marked down at the 20. I wonder if they'll take a look at the near sideline.
I think they're going to mark him out about the 46, 47 yard line. Another one of the Wolfpack weapons. Watch this hit. Bam!
Now, did he stay in?
Yeah, I think he steps out right there.
Yep.
Yeah. Officials were right on top of that as he continued to run.
Yeah, the replay booth upstairs had a quick look at it. Jerry Mosley, our replay official, on top of it.
On the return, the runner was ruled out of bounds at the 47-yard line. First down for North Carolina from that spot.
That's the right call. And the 50,000-plus in attendance displeased.
They weren't supposed to be happy. Except for those Troy fans that are here.
A bunch of them.
They didn't see what we saw.
A bunch of them made the trip at our hotel. Down the road. All right, well, 21-point lead for NC State here. And the ball. And a chance to really put this game out of reach. Brissette on first down. Tons of time. Here's Days near sideline. Days escapes a tackle. Gets past two. And is down near the 25.
Patience in the pocket by Jacoby Brissett. Watch this. Looks right, looks left, looks right again. Finds Days in the flat. And once again, when Days gets the ball in open field, he's a terror to try to tackle.
26-yard gain for Days. Matt Days, what a night. First down for NC State. Minute left to go in the third quarter. Samuels stumbling ahead for eight. And don't forget, in a couple weeks, they'll also have Shadrach Thornton back after a team suspension. Eight different targets for Jacoby Brissett. Never mind what's going on the ground tonight.
I think that was Gillespie a moment ago that just carried the ball. So that makes eight different receivers and six different guys that have carried the ball so far this evening.
Days again. Finds a hole. Gets to the 10-yard line.
He's down.
...16 seconds left in the third quarter, and NC State appears content to let the clock run. And that is what they will do. Wolfpack have doubled up the Troy Trojans at Carter-Finley Stadium. Rousing start.
That is the end of the third quarter.
For NC State. Putting up a 40 spot and then some on Troy. Jacoby Brissett having a great evening. He's had plenty of help. Brandon Burks has scored a touchdown. Jacoby Brissett may have been taken down, but it's NC State in control in Raleigh. North Carolina State in control of their season opener over the Troy Trojans. Alex Faust, Stan Luter here with you. on this Saturday evening. Rain sweeping through earlier, but things have cleared up nicely. And for NC State, it's been a night of clear sailing offensively. Brissette to the far sideline. And that's Benson Brown with his first catch of the evening. Played every game last year, mostly as a blocking tight end. Now you're bound to see those second and third strings come in. And for NC State, just as effective. Gillespie in the backfield here. And Samuels in motion. Gillespie pushing forward. Did he get there? Awfully close. Brought down at the half-yard line. It'll be enough for a first down.
I've said this a couple times, and I'll say it one more. Another guy they're very excited about, this kid, Reggie Gillespie. Played over at Southern Guilford High School in the Greensboro area, and just power. Has great speed and excellent vision. Looks like he got in. Couldn't tell where that knee touched. But again, you know, this a bevy of backs that North Carolina State has, and Reggie Gillespie may be another one of those guys that we continue to talk about along with Naeem Hames. There's a kid, Hindra, and there's a kid, Frazier kid, from out of Princeton, North Carolina, who I think they're going to redshirt this year, that had about 3,000 yards rushing and about 40 touchdowns in this senior season.
Quentin Schooley, 60, cramping up a bit there.
Dave Dorn took the job at North Carolina State. He said, you've got to protect home. You've got to win the recruiting battles at home first. And certainly over the last two seasons, they've done an outstanding job of getting homegrown talent.
This will be an injury timeout after Schooley had to be helped off the field. NC State inside the red zone looking to punch it in, up by 21. Wolfpack threatening to get back in the end zone, up by 21 over the Troy Trojans. Season opener at Carter-Finley Stadium. And for NC State, they've had plenty of options on the ground. Matt Days has had a nice night. Jalen Samuels with a trio of touchdowns. They'll come close again, but pushed back at the goal line. That's Reggie Gillespie, the freshman. We've been talking about him. Enrolled early. And again, comes up short. This time going over the top.
That's the goal line stop right there. Redick, who we've talked about a couple times, interior defense of Troy. I'd love to make the stop. You got a good look there a moment ago at number 92, Garrett Peake.
Samuels in motion. Here's Gillespie. Did he get there?
Don't think he did. Don't think
Stopped
he did.
Short again. How close can you get?
You be the judge at home. Does he break the plane?
The previous play is under review.
Hard to see it from this angle. Roundtree and Roberts and a host of other guys make the tackle. Now his head did break the play.
Yeah,
but tell me, but I don't think, I'm not certain the football did. I'm going to sit back. Last time I tried to make a decision on this, I was wrong. So I'm going to stay out of this. Let's take a look. This may give us a better angle.
Jerry Mosley might have a tough job in the replay booth. Can't see the ball there. Nice job by Sedarius Rooker too, coming in late with that extra push defensively. The freshman for Troy. Jalen Roundtree, 22, as well. I got to be honest, Stan, I don't see anything conclusive.
I saw the hit, and I saw it a second ago. But I don't think so. And like you said, it's got to be true. And I think it's a good call on the field. So we'll get NC State one more crack at it, third and one. But a great job so far. Goal line stand by the Troy Trojans. Trying to come up with a big play.
Well, if they want to stay in this ball game, this is almost a must do. It would set up a third down situation. And for NC State.
After review, the ruling on the field stands.
Yeah.
Third down.
Can't do much more than that.
This would be a good time right now if you wanted to risk it. Now, I don't see why you couldn't or wouldn't. A little play fake, jumbling just a naked boot for the set.
He's plenty fleet of foot.
See who's in the backfield. I think they're going to keep Gillespie in there.
Gillespie setting up in the backfield.
Over the top.
Ramos to the right. Brissett rolling right. Touchdown, North Carolina State. Benson Brown making the grab.
Rolled Brissett away from pressure. Brown does a great job getting in the end zone first and then clearing the shoulders. Nice, easy touchdown pass for NC State.
Well, Jacoby Brissett, a man on a mission this year. NC State a point away from putting up a 50 spot on the Troy Trojans in the season opener. Benson Brown, the graduate student, picking up the touchdown. It's all NC State in Raleigh. Had a late flag on this play. And we'll hear the penalty.
Yes. Penalty was declined.
Okay, penalty was declined. It was on the kick. Perhaps a jump early, but we'll get the call momentarily. Well, NC State, team that you know they've got a fairly smooth ride on paper to get towards ACC play. Their defense, decent. The offense, this is a nice jump start heading into a new year.
Well, I think ODU in South Alabama will play very tough. South Alabama last year went to a bowl game. And ODU 2 years ago had a very strong offense. So I think there'll be challenges for NC State, but they're getting better and better each and every week. And 49-21 shows that. So we'll see what happens the rest of the year.
NC State Wolfpack in control in Raleigh. Week one of the college football season and one of the sleeper picks potentially to win the ACC this year. They've got a lot of hurdles to dodge. But they're off to a flying start against the Troy Trojans, spotting them for 49. Teddy Rubin back to receive. Well, Stan, if you're Troy here, you've accomplished probably your goals on offense. You've had those explosive plays. It's probably the defensive side of the ball that's been the biggest struggle here tonight. But what are you looking for here in this fourth quarter from Brandon Silvers and company?
Continued execution. Let's continue to get better and better and better as we go along. Tidwell, the kid that didn't really get a lot of passes in the few minutes he played last season, I think it was like 3 out of 16. Throwing the football, and they'll give him an opportunity to make some. But I think if you're Troy, you got to be cautiously optimistic as you go on through this season. They've got a tougher game coming against, you know, Wisconsin very soon, and they'll play Miss State. But this is a team that's going to get better and better, similar to what we've said about North Carolina State.
Dallas Tidwell into the game, and Brandon Silvers, this hit earlier. Wonder if that plays a factor in wanting to keep him out the rest of the game. But Dallas Tidwell, the senior out of Gardendale, Alabama, this will be his third game Two men in the backfield for Tidwell. Here's a give to Jordan Chun. Haven't called his name all that much.
You're running a high-powered offense or offense that you want to try to get a lot of plays. A lot of that depends on tempo. And tempo comes a lot of ways, not only in practice and in the game. And so what you want to do if you're Troy is you want to continue to get these repetitions now. This game may be out of hand for them. But what they want to do is get guys used to blocking, to making plays on the point of attack, running through holes, and their quarterbacks having vision. Especially this is a good opportunity for your young Mr. Tidwell to get in.
Brandon Silvers, he's out his padding now. Launch to the sideline and broken up. Well covered by Mike Stevens. Brandon Silvers done for the day. A good night for Silvers, no doubt. Pretty much did what you would have asked of him coming into the day.
Well, he's a smart guy. We talked about that in the open, came into the past season. 191 of 271 and only four interceptions. And the thing about it is, you know, he doesn't throw for a lot of staggering numbers, but makes great plays and valued the football.
Take a Troy bounce and we'll be down at the 26. Brandon Silvers, a good outing, but he's done for the day. Troy trails by three touchdowns. Here's tonight's Capital One Impact performance, and Jalen Samuels has earned it, a three-touchdown night for the sophomore.
Got the Wolfpack off to a great start with the jet sweep and score. Then later on, second quarter, gets in the end zone, touchdown. And then just a few moments ago, just using speed to get to the outside, Samuels, who had one touchdown rushing last year, one touchdown receiving, three touchdowns on the evening today.
Quite the night for Jalen Samuels. That's our Capital One Impact performance. Jalen McClendon into the game. And much of the same for NC State. On the first play from scrimmage, that's the freshman Reggie Gillespie once again. Started to talk about him earlier. He enrolled early, participated in the spring game, got a lot of time with the first team offense. And as a senior in high school, led the state of North Carolina with 3,000 plus rushing yards, 52 yeah. touchdowns.
And the thing that to add to that is the fact that you're talking also about Gillespie, Frazier, who we may not see this season, and Hines are all in that same senior class, or part two of the three are in the senior class. But to come in and have that kind of yardage already piled up as high school stars, now they got to do it at a college level. And certainly, I have not been disappointed today by Hines the few times he's had touches, and certainly by Gillespie a few moments ago piling in for a touchdown.
Jalen McClendon, the redshirt freshman, getting some time. Former two-sport star at Mecklenburg High School in Charlotte.
Solid program over there at West Meck. And over his last 2 years, I think he threw like 39 touchdowns and 3,400 yards. That's a lot of numbers. Yeah. You start talking about this. 3,400 yards, 3,000 yards in the season, in the career. You know, 40 touchdowns. These guys, yeah. Again, Dave Dorn has done a great job. And these are all, what, North Carolina
right.
kids,
right?
He's done a great job in just capturing the state right now. And you can see it evident on the field.
And one of the better quarterback recruits in this class, too. Came in 2 years ago. Now, this NC State program, they have been building something last few years. And obviously, Dave Dorn, his first season he got here, laid the foundation. It's been great work ever since. 8-5 last season. They won their bowl game against one of the co-champions of the American Conference in UCF.
And I saw UCF really clinch it with a big win right in North Carolina down against Greenville, against East Carolina, the last second play Hail Mary. So they came into their bowl game, and they were only about an hour away from
right.
campus with a lot of momentum. And NC State started off with a little option pass and scored and carried it on, and Brissett had a solid game. Thornton, and the bowl game made all the people wearing red very happy to start 2015.
Well, and if you look at it from the sense of they had already finished the season winning three of their last four. You go into the bowl game, and we were talking with Dave Huxtable, defensive coordinator as well, and saw head coach Dave Dorn there, but you know, I get the sense that they thrived having that extra work and that reward at the end of the season, of course, to come away with a victory. There's a lot of momentum that they're carrying into this 2015 season.
You get a chance to get a lot of young guys through reps. It's a goal to go to a bowl game. You win it, that gives you some momentum for spring and winter workouts. And as we talk about this NC State team and what you're seeing them do on the field, I think if you're a Troy fan, you've got to look at them and say, hey, this is what they're doing. This is how they're building their program. Now we've got a chance in due time under Coach Brown. They're going to get some kids out of Alabama, and boom, their program is going to continue to grow. But they have laid the foundation with a great tradition.
I had the same thought the other day about this Troy program. There are a lot of seeds that have been sown, very similar to how Dave Doran has come about rebuilding this NC State program. McClendon, off of NC State's 30th first down of the night, throws this away. Coverage defensively from the Trojans. But that's really what NC State, or rather what Troy has been building for, is something similar to what they've done at NC State and building recruiting classes both in and out of state. Dave Doran has done a fantastic job everywhere he's gone, and that has continued here in Raleigh. Second down for Jalen McClendon. Getting some valuable playing time here as well. DeQuay Nichols bouncing to the outside, but swarmed quickly. Pick up a couple. And a third down for the Wolfpack. Dave Doran, as we mentioned, former head coach at Northern Illinois, got to the Orange Bowl twice, won the Mid-Atlantic Conference, or Mid-American Conference, excuse me.
Took that job in December, late December, so didn't go with the team down to the Orange Bowl. Back on the job here, trying to turn this program around.
McClendon staggers forward, nearly got to the first down marker.
And you asked Coach Doran as this week was going, okay, thinking this game could possibly get out of hand, how much would we see McClendon? So there wasn't a special time you would see him. They weren't going to try to get him in the game just to get in, as the game need be, if need be, would. This is a kid in McClendon who ran a lot of option spread in high school and grew about 7 inches between his freshman year and his senior year at West Mecklenburg, and has become one of the, you know, one of those kids that you play. Hey, he's a blue chipper, strong arm, strong legs, good mind, great upside.
He caught a glimpse there of Neil Brown. Curious to hear his take on how tonight has gone. Flag down on the play. McClendon spins out of trouble. Still with it. McClendon brought down near the far sideline.
This may be a hold on NC State, but wow, you got to be very impressed with that play by McClendon. Taking about two or three hits. Showed some great balance.
Holding on the offense, number 50. A penalty is declined. It will be first and 10 for Troy.
Another young offensive lineman,
this
Tony Adams.
This will be a timeout.
You may know his dad. His dad is the wrestling coach at Boston University.
Right.
Tony comes from Charlotte, good family, nice young man. Got caught with a holding that time, though. We got to talk about that later, Tony.
NC State in control over Troy in Raleigh. Alex Faust, Stan Luter here with you. Dallas Tidwell with a high snap. He has to fall back on top of it. NC State, one of their slogans last few years has been statements, and they have certainly made one here tonight. The other that they've been pumping up here, raising the bar, and that started from the beginning of the calendar year. After that bowl win, 8-5, okay, let's get better. Let's do one more here. This is incomplete. Tidwell took a shot. But Dave Doran, he's been asking his players, he's been asking his coaches, what's your one more? Marginal improvement every single
every day.
What's your one more?
Get better every day. If everybody buys in and everybody gets a little better, this program gets better. We're seeing that. Yeah, tonight will be five out of their last six ball games they've won. And each time you watch them, you become more and more impressed with what they're doing.
There's Tidwell on third down. Nowhere to go for Andre Flakes. Ball was on the ground. I believe he may have been down first. And indeed, that's the case.
Still being aggressive. Contact there, good play.
Oh, there
ball
go.
Pops out. Johnny on the spot. Nice tackle that time by Justin Jones.
And that was a live ball.
Yeah.
His knee came down but never touched the ground. Tidwell did well to recover as Troy will punt. Back out to midfield and a fair catch signaled by Cherry. Well, this NC State squad, we talked about it from the top of the show. You've heard it before. Dark horses in the ACC. Yeah, that word becomes a cliche after a while, but you really get a sense that it's the honest truth this season. And you get through this game, which they've already put their statement on, Eastern Kentucky next week at Old Dominion, the Conference USA, then returning a game at South Alabama, then the tests come in greater ferocity.
See, I don't know if you really can say that they're so much of a dark horse. I think maybe a team that we don't talk about because
yeah,
Clemson,
fair.
You know, because Clemson and Florida State in their division, rightly so, get so much attention.
Right.
And so maybe NC State's that team. Okay, we don't think about them because they're one of the others, so
right.
to speak. Whereas you and I and a lot of people that watch them say, you know what, this is one of those teams that can knock you off. And certainly when you come and play them here, you know, this atmosphere, and they will bring that defense and the variety they have on offense. If they are a dark horse, it's going to lighten up pretty soon.
Yeah,
people
are going to
know who they are, you know?
They will wise enough.
Yeah.
The other thing to consider for NC State, they got better by leaps and bounds as last season came along. Four out of five in your last five games. That'll tell you as much. But they've continued that improvement all the way into 2015.
Well, that's it, one more.
Yep.
That's it, one more.
And that was one of the questions coming in. Is it hitting the reset, or is it continuing where they left off last year? And I think we've gotten that answer here tonight.
You know, I think if you're scoreboard watching and schedule watching, you look at October and the game you mentioned a moment ago against Louisville, which will be here in Carter-Finley Stadium, and then, you know, on a Friday night they travel up in Blacksburg to play Virginia Tech, and you don't know how Virginia Tech's going to bounce back. They haven't had Virginia Tech type season the last couple of years, but this game on Monday night will tell us something about them. Wake Forest, which has given them a tough time in Winston-Salem, and then they play Clemson. And Clemson just took them to the woodshed last year. So, you know, you look at October, I think, as the month where, you know, this is when teams start to get better. Teams continue to develop. The non-conference schedule maybe not the most demanding, even though I think that the South Alabama game could be a challenge and the ODU game could be a challenge.
They're both on the road. That's
one of the reasons why I think it will be a challenge, because obviously those are going to be big games for those two programs, especially for Old Dominion.
Fair catch called for. This bounces well away from the original receiver. Justin Lucas will take this out. We'll take a look at some of the scores around the ACC here this weekend. That final from Thursday, a missed opportunity potentially for UNC. Duke, that's a big win on the road at Tulane, and the way that they accomplished that as well. Of course, Clemson had the targets on their back all season long. Auburn had a close one with Louisville earlier today. Texas and Florida State just getting underway.
There was a fair catch signal given. Upon possession, the ball is dead. First and 10 for Troy at that point.
That's what we thought. 2:23 to go in Raleigh. NC State all over Troy in week one. New quarterback in for the Trojans. might be enough for a first down as well.
This is the kid, Dontrell Brewer, who took snaps last season. And he's a kid that was versatile and ran the football, but didn't get a lot of time, obviously, behind Silver, but a very good athlete.
Dontrell Pruitt. Senior out of Waynesboro.
No, he's out.
Out of Laurel, Mississippi, excuse me. He'll be taken out. This is Tidwell back in. Final plays for Troy. I want to get something cooking here with Tidwell late in the game. And he'll look over the middle. Caught there. Boy, a shoestring catch for Teddy Rubin. And a big play. Brandon Silver's looking on. Troy marching downfield.
Watch this catch again. Rubin goes down low, makes the catch, able to get the shoulders turned, trying to get one more score on the board for the Trojans of Troy.
Tidwell, it's intercepted. There's your exclamation point. Mike Stevens with the pick.
Mike Stevens does a really nice job. Watch this, a quick slant. You put pressure at the line of scrimmage and he just steps inside the receiver to make the interception. Not a lot you can do. Because he doesn't get off the line of scrimmage and he makes the beat to the ball. You almost think the pass was intended for him as opposed to Flakes. Salim, I should say, but nevertheless, a good play to kind of put a statement.
Oh, we're going to use that word again.
Yeah, one more time.
There you go.
I put a statement on this evening and what North Carolina State has been able to do.
Caught a glimpse of Neil Brown there. I don't think he should come away from this game all that disappointed. He got what he was looking for out of his offense to a certain degree. You knew the defense was going to be a struggle. That's where they're young. That's where they're inexperienced. That's where they don't have much depth.
Home next week and you play a Charleston Southern team that is vastly improved at a Big South Conference and you know should welcome at home. And I know you get excited for football and the football season your home team, but this is a team that I think as we look through the season you're going to say, wow, yeah, they're pretty good. They're not bad. They're getting better every game.
It's one of those teams that you'll see improve over the course of the season just by virtue of the personnel.
No question about it.
Flendon off the fake. It's a handoff for about three.
Go up to Madison the weekend of the 19th to play Wisconsin and then South Alabama, Mississippi State. So we'll see Troy again, but tonight belongs to the Wolfpack of NC State.
Nice win in week one for Dave Doran's bunch. Pretty much everything they wanted to accomplish here. And for Jacoby Brissett, a flying start. NC State with a 49-21 victory over the Troy Trojans. Stan, your thoughts from week one here in Raleigh. This NC State team, I think, delivered on some of that hype.
You know, just a very solid effort. They executed offensively, defensively, as well as special teams. And if you're an NC State fan, you got to be very happy with the way this team performed. And very quickly, thank you to Adam, the SID, and Troy and Annabelle for all their help this week in getting us ready for week one of the football season.
Well, for our producer, Steve Johnson, director, Eric Eisenstein, for partner in crime, Stan Luter, Alex Faust saying so long from Raleigh. The final score, NC State 49, Troy 21. You can watch this entire game on replay as well as other games in our family of ESPN networks. Log on to WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.